Quadratic, how do we solve it? Your concern, I'm here to resolve it. Can't find the factors, man, so we throw up our hands and give up. Oh, there's another way. Quadratic, how do we solve it? Your concern, I'm here to resolve it. Can't find the factors, man, so we throw up our hands and give up. No, there's a better way.
The other day I was sitting down completing the square. It takes so much time and I have none to spare. I wonder what would happen if I tried for the general case. Would I find a more efficient way? Would it save me time? Or would I find the time has simply been an utter waste? Who knows? Let's find out. I thought, what the heck, how bad could it be? So I left the coefficients as a general ABC. What fell into my hands was very worth my time, and the wealth of information should begin to blow my mind. Not stuck in a rut when my roots aren't rational. This works so well, it'll soon go national. Start with negative B in our new revolution. Plus and a minus give us not one, but every solution. Next, under the radical sign, place a B squared minus 4AC. This tells us the type of roots are the real or imaginary. So far, so good, you say. A piece of cake, but to avoid mistakes, we need another piece. 2A goes in the bottom of the fraction to complete our formulaic attraction. So I dump it now, but with a little reflection, I'm sure you'll stumble upon a great many connections.
Quadratic, how do we solve it? Your concern, I'm here to resolve it. Can't find the factors, man, so we throw up our hands and give up. Oh, there's another way.